Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. Welcome to my class. In this class, we are going to discuss Planck's quantum theory. And Max Planck proposed this theory by observing hard body radiations. What he observed? If any hard body is taken, it neither emits nor absorbs energy continuously. Once again, any hard body neither emits nor absorbs energy continuously. Means the emission of energy by a hard body is discontinuous, or the absorption of energy by a hard body is discontinuous. This was proposed by Max Planck in his theory, Planck's quantum theory. So according to Planck's quantum theory, we can understand that any hard body is going to absorb energy or going to emit energy in a discontinuous manner and in the form of small packets. Every small packet is called as quanta or quantum. Once again, when a hard body is going to emit radiation, the emitted radiation is in discontinuous form and in a small packets. Every small packet is called as quanta or quantum. Suppose here I am taking a hard body. Suppose if it is considered as a hard body, and the hard body is going to emit some radiation. The emitted radiation is having some energy. The energy of emitted radiations always directly proportional to frequency of emitted radiations. This was proposed by Max Planck in his Planck's quantum theory. So here, what we can understand, energy of emitted radiations by a hard body is directly proportional to frequency of emitted radiations of that hard body. Instead of taking emitted radiation, we can also say absorbed radiation. Absorbed radiation, because hard bodies can also absorb the energy. So the absorbed radiations having some energy, that energy of the absorbed radiation of a hard body is directly proportional to frequency of absorbed radiations of hard body. So formula is capital E proportional to or directly proportional to nu. Now we can write the formula. Capital E is proportional to nu. To remove the proportionality symbol, some constant is given, small h into nu. Here h stands for Planck's constant. And the value is given as 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second. Here, observe the unit. What is the unit given here? Joules second. Once again, Planck's constant, small h, is equal to 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second. And the Planck's constant is also represented in x. So the h value, Planck's constant value, is also represented in x. 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 27 x second. So this is the constant value we have to remember. And in the Planck's quantum theory, what the Max Planck is going to express means energy of emitted radiation of a hard body is directly proportional to frequency of emitted radiation of a hard body, or energy of absorbed radiation of a hard body is directly proportional to frequency of absorbed radiation of that hard body. This was explained by Max Planck, and Max Planck is going to say that the emission or absorption of energy is discontinuous. So whenever radiations are going to emit in a discontinuous manner, that radiations are going to form discontinuous spectrum. spectrum. All of you know rainbow. What is rainbow? When it is going to be formed? Can anybody say what is a rainbow? When it is going to be formed? What is a rainbow? When it is going to be formed? Whenever rainfall is going to happen in one particular direction. Suppose rainfall is happening in the east direction, the rainbow is going to be formed on the opposite direction. Once again, my statement. Of course, to form the rainbow, the sunrise must be required. So rainbows are observed only in the sunlight, in the presence of sunlight. Whenever the rainfall is happening in the presence of sunlight, to the opposite direction of the rainfall, we can observe the rainbow. And rainbow contains 7 colors. What are the 7 colors of rainbow? What are the 7 colors of rainbow? Yes, all of us know that is VBCR. All of us know VBCR. Rainbow is containing 7 colors. The rainbow is containing 7 colors, VBCR. And VBCR is an example of which spectrum it is. VBCR is a visible spectrum of electromagnetic radiations. Once again, VBCR is a visible spectrum of electromagnetic radiation. Visible means we can able to see. What we can see? All these colors we can see. And if you observe the rainbow, the formation of rainbow, between one color to another color, is there any gap is present? Between one color to another color, is there any gap is present? Is there any gap is present between one color to another color in the rainbow? Yes, there is no gap is present. There is no gap is present. Means which type of spectrum that is? It is a continuous spectrum. So VBCR, which is a visible spectrum, and the VBCR is an example of which type of spectrum that is? Continuous spectrum. VBCR is an example of continuous spectrum. But whenever a hot body is taken, hot body is neither going to emit nor going to absorb the energy continuously. Means the hot body is going to emit or absorb energy discontinuously. Means the hot bodies are going to form. The hot bodies are going to form which type of spectrums? The hot bodies are going to form which type of spectrums? Hot body is going to form which type of spectrum? Hot body is going to form discontinuous spectrum. It is not invisible, discontinuous. We have to say discontinuous because hot body is not going to emit energy continuously. The hot body is not going to absorb energy continuously. So the hot bodies are going to form which type of spectrums? The hot bodies are going to form discontinuous spectrums. This was observed by the scientist Max Planck. So Max Planck observed that whenever a hot body is taken, the hot body is going to form a discontinuous spectrum. Body, for example, as I am a body, this is a body. Any body is contained matter. Matter is composed of atoms. Once again, any body is containing matter. Matter is composed of atoms and molecules. Yes, exactly. Atoms and molecules. Of course, ions are also present. Of course, I am considering an atom. Suppose if it is a body, it is going to contain so many number of atoms. And this body is able to absorb energy. This body is able to emit energy in the discontinuous forms. So the atoms and the molecules, once again, the atoms and the molecules, they are going to form which type of spectrum? The atoms and molecules are going to form which type of spectrum? Yes, very good. The atoms and molecules are going to form discontinuous spectrum. All this is the observation made by the scientist Max Planck. So Max Planck is saying that whenever a hot body is taken, the hot body is going to emit or absorb energy discontinuously in small packets. Small packets of energy. Small packets of energy is emitted or absorbed, small packets of energy is emitted or absorbed by the hot bodies or by a body, and that small packet of energy, the small packet of energy, that small packet of energy is called quanta. Quanta. See the word here, quanta. What is meant by quanta? What is meant by quanta? The small packet of energy released by or absorbed by hot body is called as quanta, and this is also termed as a photon, not the proton. It is not the proton, it is a photon. So a photon means, what is meant by a photon? What is meant by a photon means? Photon means a small packet of energy either absorbed or emitted, by a body is called photon. It's called photon. And according to Max Planck, what is the formula of energy given? The formula of energy is given as capital E is equal to S. What is capital E? What is capital E? Capital E is equal to H nu. H nu. Here, capital E stands for energy of one photon. Once again, here capital E stands for, capital E stands for energy of one photon. Energy of one photon. Yes, you have to remember this word because we are going to solve some problems based on this formula. E, capital E means energy of one photon, that is equal to H into nu. And all of you know, nu is equal to, what is nu? Nu means frequency. What is nu? Nu means frequency of emitted radiation. The frequency of emitted radiation is equal to C by lambda. Here C stands for velocity of light or speed of light. Lambda means wavelength of emitted radiations or wavelength of absorbed radiations. So nu is equal to C by lambda. In this formula, capital E is equal to H nu. Nu is going to be replaced by C by lambda. Then we can write the formula, capital E is equal to, capital E is equal to H C by lambda. Capital E is equal to H C by lambda. What is capital E? Capital E is the energy of one photon. Right. If energy of one photon is, if energy of one photon is H nu, if the energy of one photon, energy of one photon, if energy of one photon, capital E is equal to H nu. Now tell me, what is the energy of n photons? N means small n. We don't know how many photons are there. Whether one photon is there, or two photons are there, three photons are there, we don't know. Then the number of photons is taken as, the number of photons is taken as small n. Then we have to say energy of n photons, small n photons, energy of n photons. Again, the formula is same, capital E. But now what we have to write, the energy of n photons, capital E is equal to, yes, text me. You know energy of one photon. Then you have to calculate energy of n photons. Then what is the formula? Capital E is equal to, capital E is equal to energy of n photons. Capital E is equal to how much? Yes, very good. E is equal to small n, once again, small n. It is not the capital N. Here, energy of n photons is equal to small n into H nu. Okay, fine. All of you know one mole. one mole. What is meant by one mole? What is the value of one mole? One mole is also known as Avogadro number. One mole is also known as Avogadro number. Yes, tell me, what is the value of Avogadro number? Already the basic concepts of chemistry, I think so, you studied about this value. What is the Avogadro number? What is the value of Avogadro number? What is the value of Avogadro number? Yes, correct. The value of Avogadro number is 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. Of course, my dear students, you will get a doubt. Sir, the value should be written as 6.022. Of course, we can also write the value as 6.023. For your convenience, for your memory purpose, simply I am going to replace 2 with 3. Here 23, here it is 23. You can easily remember the value. So Avogadro number can also be taken as 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. Yes, now you know the one mole. One mole means Avogadro number. And Avogadro number, it is a number. Number is indicated by N. And Avogadro, starting with A, then we can write the symbol. What is the symbol of Avogadro number? The symbol of Avogadro number is NA. NA stands for Avogadro number, or that is equal to 1 mole, and the value is given as 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. Now, I want to know energy of 1 mole of photons. I want to know energy of 1 mole of photons. Energy of 1 mole of photons. Energy of 1 mole of photons, capital E is equal to, yes, text me your answer. Energy of 1 mole of photons. Energy of 1 mole of photons, capital E is equal to, what is the capital E? Yes, very good, correct. Avogadro number multiplied with energy of 1 photon. Avogadro number multiplied with energy of 1 photon. Energy of 1 photon is, energy of 1 photon is h nu. So finally we can write the formula. Capital E is equal to capital N into h nu. Once again, capital E is equal to capital N into h nu. Here capital N stands for, capital N stands for Avogadro number. Capital N stands for Avogadro number. That is equal to 1 mole. 1 mole. And the value is given as 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. So this is the formula. My dear students, suppose I am going to write the formula. Capital E is equal to small n into h nu. Once again, capital E is equal to small n into h nu. Here, small n stands for what? Small n stands for what? The small n represents. What the small n represents? Yes, correct. Small n represents, here, small n represents number of photons. Small n represents number of photons. Yes, take the screenshot of this one. Based on these two formulas, we are going to solve the two problems. First, take the screenshot. And of course, I'm also sending the PDF regarding this concept. Because Planck's quantum theory, it is important for either 3 marks or 5 marks. I don't know exactly what is the weightage of this question, but it is a very, very, very important one, Planck's quantum theory. In the Zeeweth material, already we said you have to follow the Zeeweth material for your PU level. Please try to purchase the Zeeweth material. There you can find the question and answers. From starting onwards, you have to practice the question and answers. By listening the class and then by practicing the question and answers, you can easily understand the topic. Right? Thank you. Thank you for your response. Right, coming to the point here, Planck's quantum theory. Finally, the Planck's quantum theory says that emission of energy or absorption of energy by the electrons in the atoms. Because we are studying about chemical reactions. chemical reactions are due to exchange of electrons, or chemical reactions are due to transfer of electrons, but not due to protons and neutrons, because the protons and neutrons are present in the nucleus. If the nucleus containing the protons and neutrons are involving in the reactions, such reactions are called as nuclear reactions. But we are studying about only chemical reactions. In the chemical reactions, there is only the involvement of electrons. So Planck's quantum theory says that whenever an electron, suppose this is an electron, this is an electron, whenever an electron is present in an atom, the electron is going to emit energy, or the electron is going to absorb the energy in the discontinuous manner and in the form of small packets. Every pocket is called as quanta or quantum, right? We can write the formula simply E is equal to h nu, and we can write the formula E is equal to n h nu. We can write the formula E is equal to capital N into h nu, right? From these formulas, we can understand that. What we can understand? We can write E is equal to h nu, or we can also write E is equal to 2 h nu, or we can write E is equal to 3 h nu, E is equal to 4 h nu, and so on. E is equal to n h nu. Now, if you observe the difference between these two, what is the difference between these two? What is the difference between E is equal to h nu and E is equal to 2 h nu? The difference is h nu. H nu plus h nu, 2 h nu. And the difference between these two is also h nu. The difference between these two also h nu. The difference between these two is also h nu. So the difference between energy of one orbit to another orbit, the difference between energy of one photon to another photon, not orbit, energy of one photon to another photon, successive photons. These are the successive photons. So the difference between the energies of successive photons is always same. Once again, my statement, the difference between the energies of successive photons is always the same. This is known as quantization of energies of electrons in the atoms. Quantization of energies of electrons in the atoms. So the quantization of energies of electrons in the atoms is explained by Planck's quantum theory. Planck's quantum theory says that emission of energy by the electron in the atom, or the absorption of energy by the electron in the atom, takes place in a discontinuous manner, and the emission or absorption takes place in the form of small pockets. Every small pocket is called as quanta, right? This is all about Planck's quantum theory, and I am going to share the screen regarding this topic. I am going to share the screen. After the completion of the class, I am going to send the PDF. Yes, you can go through that PDF to understand in an easy manner. Yes, this is the Planck's quantum theory. I am not going to re-explain here. Just I am going to show you. So after the class completion, I am going to send this PDF. Just simply you can read this one. You can easily understand today's class. So this is all about today's class. Of course, still time is there. Wait a minute. We have to explain some problems. So this is the notes of today's class, my dear students. I'm going to send to all of you. Right, coming to the problems. Yes, please note down the problem. This is from your NCERT Chemistry Class 11. The textbook is NCERT Chemistry Class 11 textbook. From this textbook, problem number 2.6. Please note down the problem. Yes, the question given is, calculate the energy of 1 mole of photons radiations whose frequency is 5 into 10 to the power of 14 hz. Hz means hz. Hedges is the unit of. Hedges is the unit of. Text me your answer. Hedges is the unit of. Hedges is the unit of frequency. Once again, hedges is the unit of frequency. Here, the value is given as 5 into 10 to the power of 14 hedges. 5 into 10 to the power of 14 hedges indicating that it is a frequency. So in the problem, nu frequency is given. So from that nu or the frequency, we are going to calculate energy of 1 mole of photons. Yes, text me your answer. What is the formula to calculate the energy of 1 mole of photons? What is the formula used to calculate energy of 1 mole of photons? What is the formula used to calculate energy of 1 mole of photons? Sweta, it is not h nu. E is equal to h nu indicates energy of 1 photon. E is equal to capital N into h nu indicates energy of 1 mole of photons. Try to solve it. Otherwise, on the screen, you can see the answer. Please note down. Energy of 1 photon, capital E is equal to h nu. Once again, energy of 1 photon, capital E is equal to h nu. And energy of 1 mole of photons. Energy of 1 mole of photons, capital E is equal to energy of 1 photon. Energy of 1 photon multiplied with Avogadro number. So energy of 1 mole of photons is equal to energy of 1 photon multiplied with Avogadro number. Yes, the formula is energy of 1 photon h nu into Avogadro number is capital N. Yes, all of us know h value, small h value. H value is 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules a second. Joules a second. On the board I'm going to write. Right. On the board I'm going to write. So energy of 1 mole of photons is equal to capital N into h nu. Here capital N is equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 into h value. What we have to take the h value? What we have to take the h value? What we have to take the h value? Can anybody answer? What we have to take the h value? H value is 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34. Joules a second is taken here. Joules a second is taken into nu. Nu means frequency. How much frequency is given? In the problem, how much frequency is given? How much frequency is given in the problem? Yes, 5 into 10 to the power of 14. In the problem, the frequency is given as 5 into 10 to the power of 14. Yes, my dear students, this is the calculation. You have to simplify. You have to simplify the answer. You have to simplify the answer. Try yourself. And finally, you have to write the answer. The answer is capital E is equal to dash. Some value. And here, what are the units? For this problem, what is the unit? What is the unit? Because we are calculating the energy. And the H value is given as 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules a second is given. That means energy is coming in the unit of joules. So finally, the unit is joules is the unit. And regarding this unit in the MCQs, whether it may be in the CET or NEET, the questions will be asked and the same answers will be given with different units. First option, same answer with a different unit. Second option, same answer with a different unit. Third option, same answer with a different unit. So whenever heavy calculations are given, the answers are going to be same, but the units are going to be different. That means the calculated value is going to be same, but the units are going to be different. So you have to remember the units also. So finally, the energy of one mole of photons, how much value it is? How much value it is? Yes, on the screen you can see the value and calculation. Both answer and calculation is given on the screen. Just note down that one. And this type of questions is asked for 2 marks in the PU level. In the PU level, 2 marks. For 2 marks or maybe for 3 marks, the question will be asked. Important one. So try to practice once again. After the completion of the classes, when you are having the leisure time, you have to practice the same concepts and problems. Then only you can understand very well, you can remember very well. Right, going to the last problem, today's class. Yes, on the screen you can see one more question, one more problem. One more problem, note down the problem. Problem 2.7. Problem 2.7. A 100-watt bulb, a 100-watt bulb, regularly in our home, we are using the bulbs, round-shaped bulbs. The round-shaped bulbs, generally we use 60-watt bulbs for the normal uses. In the bedrooms, we use generally 0-watt or 5-watt bulbs. Here, how much watt of bulb is given? 100-watt bulb is given, and the bulb is going to emit monochromatic light. Monochromatic light means, what is meant by monochromatic lights? A light having only one type of radiation, or the light is going to have only one type of wavelength. That is the monochromatic light. So a 100 watt bulb emits monochromatic light of wavelength 400 nanometers. Calculate the number of photons emitted by the bulb per second. So a bulb is going to emit some radiation. Which type of bulb is given? The power of the bulb is 100 watt bulb is given, and it is going to emit a radiation having a wavelength of 400 nanometers. Then in 1 second, per second means 1 second, how many photons are going to be emitted by the bulb? Yes, on the screen you can see the calculation. The time is very less. In the next class we will discuss. Otherwise, by seeing the answer on the screen, if you are able to understand, just practice yourself in the next class. Means not in the tomorrow. Because tomorrow again I am on the leave. Because I have some personal work. So tomorrow there is no class of mine. So during that time, if you are not having any class, please practice today's problems. Okay, so this is the answer on the screen. I'm going to send the PDF also. No need to worry. Very less time is there. Yes, you have to text once again whether the class is understood or not. And are you having any doubt regarding this class? Are you having any doubt regarding this class? Please text me your response in the chat box. And one more thing. Today in my class timetable, that is in my class period time, our HOD sir, Suresh sir, is going to take the class. Our HOD sir will take the class in my time. By tomorrow. Yes, text me if the class is understood or not. If you are having any doubt, you have to call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. only. Excluding the holidays. Yes, thank you one and all for watching my video lectures. Please watch the recorded videos till the end. If you are unable to understand, please watch the recorded videos till the end with some patience. Stay home, stay safe. Have a nice day. This is your chemistry lecturer, Sesdar Naidu, signing off. Have a nice day.